Hey guys, and welcome back to the second part of my Disneyland Paris hotel build. So it's Sim here today, and I just wanted to start off this video by thanking you guys for all your sweet and great comments that I got on my videos. It really means a lot to me. It really brightens my day to read all the comments, and of course it really helps with the building because sometimes I get a bit insecure and I don't know if I'm on the right track, but when I read your comments it makes me feel so good and it gives me a lot of confidence to continue, so thank you for that. You just saw me adding some flower beds on the front of the hotel because I thought it looked a bit empty and it needed something there, so I just thought, well, why not put in some more flowers, because you can't have enough flowers surrounding the hotel, because in real life there are like a million flowers in the gardens as well. So here I just added in two seating areas for your Sims to enjoy their dinner because they are connected. So this one is connected to the restaurant and the other seating area is connected to the bistro that I made, or cafe. So your Sims can enjoy their romantic dinner with their partners or just a croissant in the bistro. And yeah, I really liked how that looked. I did play around with the build in my own game here because I do test everything, and the bistro does work, and I also put in a grand piano and I did add some princesses to the game as well, and they absolutely just loved relaxing in the bistro and just playing on the grand piano. I know Belle did, she went on that a lot. I really, for the pictures that I make in, I always do like screenshots at the end of the video. You can see the princesses as well. I did edit them into the screenshots because I just had so much fun playing in the hotel, and I hope you guys will have a fun playing with it as well. So here I'm doing the backyard landscaping, adding in all of the flowers, and I wasn't happy with the landscaping at first. I think I over cluttered it a bit. Just too much different flowers, I think, was the problem. But I do adjust that somewhere in the middle of the video, I think. I do remove some flowers and it looks much better. I really do like the flowers of the new stuff pack from the Romantic Garden stuff pack. I do use them in all of my games now because I think they are beautiful, and it just has a lot of recolors which I'm very happy with. But the red flower that I'm using right now is going to disappear again. I just thought it clashed a bit with the rest of the flowers, so I'm going to take them out eventually. Also, I'm putting in the fountain from the romantic stuff pack as well, so the wishing well is going to come to the side and the fountain is going to be added in the middle because I just thought it looked a bit more grand. And of course I really like the gameplay of the fountain as well, so your Sims can play in the fountain with their children, which I thought would be a lot of fun if you have your Sims staying in the hotel. Here just adding in the little rocks. I just thought that looked a bit more romantic than using fences as borders. I do use fences at the front, but at the back I just wanted a bit more of a romantic feel, and that's why I'm using the stones as a border. For the inside of the house, I will be adding in a gift shop. Of course, there is going to be a bistro, a restaurant, a kitchen attached to the bistro, some check-in balis. I don't know if I'm saying that correctly, if you call them balis. Check-in counters, I think is the word. I'm so sorry. There are like two, one on each side, so your Sims can check in there into their rooms. So yeah, here I'm just doing seating areas throughout, oops, sorry, throughout the garden, and there will also be seating areas at the front of the hotel as well. So I looked up what these little buildings are called in English, and there are gazebos. I don't know if I'm saying that correctly, but I just couldn't find the correct word for it in the last video. But there are gazebos, which you guys obviously already knew. So yeah, I'm just adding in some chairs and benches as well, and I did add in a easel because I thought it was would be nice if your Sims could just relax and maybe make paint the garden. I thought that would be nice for your Sims to do. So yeah, that's why I added in a easel as well. So in a minute we are going to go into the hotel. So here I'm adjusting the garden. So here I'm just removing those red flowers, and I'm going to be replacing them with more daisies, and here are those flowers from the romantic garden as well. I just scale them up, and I think that looks a bit more romantic. So very sorry if I'm sounding a bit weird today and out of breath, but I think I'm getting a cold because my throat is really hurting. So very sorry if I'm sounding a bit weird. So here we're going into the inside, just adding the lights. I'm sorry, I forgot how that was called, with how they were called. So yeah, here I'm doing the staircase, just figuring out how I wanted them to go. I did try and to make them look exactly like the real life hotel, and I think I managed to do that, but the stairs on the third floor aren't there in real life, they're somewhere else, but it just it did came out better for me to put them at the back, because I'm going to be adding two suites on the fourth floor. I'm going to try and build the Sleeping Beauty suite and the Waltz suite, or I think the Tinkerbell suite, I'm not sure how they are called, but I'm going to try and build them on the fourth floor. So the third floor is going to be the Castle Club hotel rooms. They are a bit bigger and luxurious than the normal hotel rooms, and the normal hotel rooms are going to be coming on the second floor, and I am going to be building the Fantasia bar there. The Fantasia bar, not the Fantasia. Fantasia is something else, that's from True Blood. I mean the Fantasia bar. You have that in the real life hotel as well, and I think it's on the first on the second floor. So I'm going to try and make it look a bit similar as that bar as well. So here I am doing the balcony of the suites, which I think looked very nice there. I don't know if there is a balcony like that in the real hotel. I don't think it is, but I really liked how that looked on that spot. So here I'm doing the first floor, just figuring out where I wanted everything. So of course I needed to add in the red carpet. There is a red carpet in the real life hotel, but it has like really a lot of detailing in it, and I think it's like little flowers, a bit of green I think as well, but yeah, we don't have that in the game, so I just settled for a red carpet, and I think that looks really nice. So I am going to do the check-in right here. There are going to be two on either side of the hotel, so your Sims can check in on left or on the right side, because it does tend to get really busy on holidays in the hotel, so two check-ins are of course necessary. I didn't want to overclutter it, so I don't put anything on the wall except like a sign and two cameras, and I do put in three computers as well, so that your Sims can get checked in. I think they use like from those little touchscreen not tablets because they're like inside of the counters. And I was thinking on just putting in tablets, but I thought no, let's put in some computers that looked much better. And also a little fence so that the hotel guest won't come in and use their computers for their own personal needs, of course. So for the lobby, I am putting in a lot of seating areas for your Sims, because of course they need, there is also a lot of, not a lot of lines. There is usually a big line so they can just wait their turn to check in. I'm so sorry, I think I'm rambling and very sorry for that. So yeah, I did do a bit of furnishing of the lobby off screen because I just thought the video was going to be a bit long. It was like 40 minutes long, and I just cut that part out. I also cut out the part where I do the lightings as well. But it wasn't really like, yeah, that wasn't really fun to watch or anything like that. It's just me putting in some lights, so you didn't miss anything very important. Also, added in some columns because I just thought it looked a bit unsupported. You have like this big gap of the balcony and nothing to support it. So I just thought let's put in some columns, and it did look much better as well. And I really like the contrast of the red and the green seats. It really looks nice. I think it's also green in the hotel, but I'm not sure to be honest. But I just thought that that was the color that looked best at the lobby. Oh my gosh, I'm forgetting words, and I'm very, very sorry for that. So yeah, here I'm just putting in some decorational flooring. This is not going to stay that way. I am going to be changing that a bit because I just thought it looked a bit boring, and I'm going to make it a bit different. So here I'm starting the gift shop. I really love this gift shop. It looks really nice, and I had just a lot of fun building this gift shop as well. I do love building shops. That is one of my favorite things to do. And I know I only have built like one other shop. I think it was my Halloween shop, but I also am planning on doing more shops as well. So yeah. Oh, what else did I want to tell you guys? Oh yeah, the spa. So the spa area is going to come in the basement. In the real life hotel, it's like in a side wing of the hotel, but I haven't built the entire hotel, so I didn't have a side wing to put it. And of course, I could have put the spa on the second floor, but I really wanted to have a swimming pool, and that's why I'm putting it in the basement. But I do think it's going to look nice. I am still going to have to start on that, but I think it's going to look nice. I have like a tons of really fun ideas for it. So yeah, hopefully I will be doing that in the next episode. I think I have covered everything you guys needed to know for this build. Yeah, I think I have. So I hope that you guys enjoy the rest of this build. If you have like a comment or a suggestion about this build. Oh yeah, I know I'm forgetting something. So sorry. So I did add in some hidden Mickeys in the build. I don't know if you saw them in the first video, but at the end of this video, I have counted 5 hidden Mickeys. Well, not really hidden because they're not that hidden, of course, but if you did spot them, I really would like to know that in the comment section below the video, and what you guys think of that. I am planning on adding some hidden Mickeys throughout the entire hotel. I just thought it gives it a bit more extra. I don't know how I'm going to add them, but I'm going to try and add them because yeah, I'm do. Oh my god, so sorry. My words are just going all over the place, so I am not going to use any custom content. So I'm going to try and make Mickeys, of course, with what I have in the game right now. Okay, I'm going to stop talking now. So I hope that you guys enjoyed the rest of this build. If you do, please hit the like button. If you love it, subscribe. And hopefully I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.
voice that carries them has kept me astray. Too soon to act on it, can we ever be? That all depends on what you're feeling from me.
Let me show you all the way.
Let me show you all the ways. Oh, oh. Let me show you all the ways.
Savannah, we'll never be alone, Savannah.